Hello and welcome. We're back again. We had a little bit of a break over the weekend, but Sunday, and we've got another best of three for you here from Mr. Cat. The draft is ready, and we've got two cracking teams getting ready to battle it out as I turn on the sound to get everything ready. And we're good to go. We're good to go. Secret against PD in this best of three for the Mr. Cat EU Invitational. PD went all the way through the group stages, through the winner bracket, beat NIP at the end, and got themselves into the playoffs while Team Secret were waiting for them as an invited team. And honestly, PD have got their work cut out for them. My co-caster Trent is here with me as well. What do you think about this series?
Kraken teams. I liked it. That's so British of you. Team Secret. Very much looking forward to this. I think we all understandably are expecting Secret to certainly do to do better. That should be what they're expecting as well. I'm sure that's what Pro Dota, you know, they know where they reside next to these guys, but they're obviously still hoping to take the victory here. I know they have been boot camping for quite a while, so hoping to see some serious progression in the squad, taking things very seriously this time in the lead up to TI. I believe they actually have the backing of Kamal, if I'm not mistaken. So it's actually Kamal-backed Pro Dota now up against Team Secret.
I'd be careful with saying backing. I know that they're boot camping at the facilities that Kamal owns and used to be the Secret, you know, team house. Yes. And boot camp and stuff. But I don't know if they're being funded. I don't know if they're, like, actually being, you know, run by. I don't know what's happening.
Oh, no, I'm not saying run by. But, I mean, they're like, in their house, man. They took their house. They took their space. Like,
claimed it. It's ours now. Well,
now they will take their title in Mr. Cat.
You know, PD's run through the upper bracket was not easy by any means. They 2-1 Vega, 2-1 C+4, but they ended up 2-0ing NIP in a very, very kind of messy, close series, even though the scoreline might not indicate that.
Yes.
They ended up with not base races, but kind of team fights that were outside bases and ended very strangely. But PD have been doing okay against other teams as well. The trouble is, Team Secret have been doing, like, exceptionally for the past 3 months, right? Or 2 months or so. You know, they may be dropping games in Dream League against, you know, Empire and people like that, but those are best of twos. But if you look at the best of threes and series that Secret have been playing, they've been winning them. I don't think they've dropped a series in quite a while now.
Yeah, for a while, they were the only team in Dream League who were even getting 2-0s, and that has changed in the past just couple days. But other than that, like, for the majority of Dream League opening up, it was just all 1-1s across the board, and Secret was the only team that was able to, like, finish off a couple of opponents there. So fresh off that 1-1 with Team Liquid, which was also a very nice series. Well, they're looking to get things done here. So once again, they are going to go with the Crystal Maiden opener. This has been very standard for them. And they're also going to take care of that Clockwork, Radiant, who to me is probably one of the more interesting guys in the meta right now. Just like, certain teams seem to really want to go for that opener of Clockwork. Like, they see him as that new age Mirana kind of deal, where he can be off lane or he can be in this, like, position four, whereas Mirana was more like kind of this either roaming four or mid hero, but that same flexibility during the drafting phase. Super strong, has a lot of different heroes that can obviously combo up with him, has a lot of strategies he can combo with. He counters strategies in the global split push game just because of his reach and catch. So no wonder that you're seeing Pro Dota pick him up first every single game. And, well, the Grape Crusader himself is back in Darkseer.
Yeah, nice. And Clockwork in the offlane with a Pullman Shield is unkillable, you know? We've seen so many times he's gone into 1v2 or 1v3 lanes and just walked into creep waves, harassed enemy safe laners, killed off supports, found double kills, and all sorts of nonsense. It's a very, very difficult hero to kind of handle in lane. As well as the, you know, you're talking about combos, as gimmicks with, like, Ricky Cloud, Phoenix Sunray, the Shadow Fiend
Skywrath,
the Shadow Fiend Souls that we see people do in the Fountain to kill the cogs off to get more damage, but none of that this game. None of that this game. Weaver banned out by PD, something that we talk a lot about when we kind of, you know, skirt the subject of Secret, is how they attribute heroes and roles, because they are quite clear cut. And, you know, mid one is kind of their, you know, he's their star player, but he's also the player that they kind of build drafts around. And that's not to
take. Well, I was gonna say this has to be the Bristle ban too, as well, right? And that same idea.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Omni plus Bristle plus Maiden, you've got permanent
Cross, like,
Spray,
no way
plus Repel. It's disgusting. But yeah, he's not, you know, not to take anything away from the rest of the players, but they definitely do build drafts around him. MP has shown a lot more success on kind of, you know, early tempo controlling carries, where by 20 minutes he's just ready to go and destroy buildings and fight, while mid one is more, you know, play like Ember Spirit and Evoker is playmaking heroes that maybe take a little more time from the mid lane to get up and running. PD, are there any sort of players that we want to look out from on that team?
I think Garter is an exceptionally talented guy, 3-3, also unbelievably good. I think he's probably the guy who's like shown some of the bigger moments. And I think a lot of those were on some offlane Clockworks, if I'm not mistaken, where I was watching some of his games where I was like, damn, dude, this guy, he still got it. But like when he first showed up playing with Kai-P, he looked fantastic. He's got a great Bat Rider too, although he doesn't get to show it off too much. Plays a very good Legion Commander. So I always look towards him to kind of set that pace in terms of how their game plan goes. And then just Garter overall, just he always seems to shine too in their games.
Yeah, Garter's decision-making always seems very, very strong. Magnus has been ignored, and we've seen that kind of precedent set for the past maybe 2.5 weeks, where Magnus has shifted from being first phase pick or ban to kind of just being left out to dry and not being picked at all. You know, the opener Magnus Jug used to be so strong, but now people have kind of found ways to play around it, make sure that Juggernaut doesn't just flash farm jungle, make sure that your spacing and spreading is correct in team fights so you don't get hit by those big RPs. It's a little bit easier to deal with Magnus nowadays, but are there any other big reasons why we're not seeing the mag picked anymore?
I don't know so much. Like when I think about Magnus and problems with him, like maybe he can suffer quite a bit from the Monkey King, who was still left in the pool. So we've been seeing like it's kind of like a Baden where you just get zoned out of the lane. And yes, you can jungle as Magnus, but it's pretty weak early on. Whereas someone like Darkseer just has better flexibility in terms of pushing the wave and messing with the lane, as well as being a lot faster in the jungle. So he can handle the Monkey King, I think, a little bit better. So if you were gonna pick, like, I wouldn't want to go Mag Jug in this opener just because then I'm gonna get like Crystal Maiden Monkey King or something, and they're just gonna like totally destroy my offlane. So I think the Darkseer kind of protected them from that. So, I don't know. I think Magnus, if he could make that position 4 role work, like some people
the
were.
The GH,
like,
the GH jungle Magnus, yeah.
I mean, that's kind of flexible right here, honestly, with an Io. I could see it.
That could be cool. Well, the Milan Io was picked up. That's something they've been playing around with a lot. But the Yapzor Earthshaker. Now, we've seen PD play that ES for Milan, and they do that kind of nifty offlane, you know, block and pull into the camps, and then you get yourself experience and gold there. I don't think I've seen Yapzor do it too often. Mainly he plays the kind of sit behind people and wait for the moment to strike or the initiation from fog with that long range Fisher kind of play style with your ES. But
and they've been running that Kezu Shaker too, but of course with the Omni Knight, I think we are assuming that it should be. I mean, we've seen a couple position for Omni. It's definitely been pretty underwhelming, at least in my opinion. So I don't know if CM Aura would really do enough to offset that. In my eyes, I agree. I think it should just be the old Yappy Hot 4 Shaker.
Ooh. Is this a 4-roll Nyx with no setup stuns?
That is exactly what it is, but it is something to combo with the Darkseer at the very least, but not exactly the easiest of executions.
So now for PD, like Nyx Assassin is a great hero that we've seen in the past combo with Wisp as well. You know, you've got the Vendetta to scout out and get information, you relocate on top of the Vendetta strike and the Impale from Nyx. But you don't really have anyone to kind of follow through with a relocate in just yet. Juggernaut's not amazing. You like relocate Omni Slash, but
I really like the Bristle now, man.
For Team
all
Secret.
The stuff you're bringing up, yeah. Like, I mean, I know they've run it offlane and the safe lane. I think they lost the safe lane game against Na'Vi, but honestly,
mid Bristle, dude.
Yeah, like, I mean, mid IO plus one. Yeah, that he is the counter, right? Like, he's the guy I used to send mid against IO plus ones.
Yeah, and now he's, you know, incredibly strong with, like we said, with the Crystal Maiden Aura and Repel for the mid game. You've got so much kind of sustain, not just HP, but mana as well for you. And mid one has played it as well.
Spells. Yeah, so much of their spells right now on Pro Dota are balanced around AoE. So, like, the whole idea of, like, Darkseer and Nyx Assassin, the way I always look at that stuff is that they're going to have lower damage values because they're balanced around the idea that you can hit numerous heroes. So, whenever you have a draft that has a lot of those AoE values, then Bristleback generally does very well against them because you're spamming all of these weakened AoE spells at this one dude who you just can't kill.
10 seconds,
but Troll Warlord still synergizes well with the Bristle, so the option is definitely still open if they want to go for it, but should be someone to be peeping away in this mid lane and Pro Dota not allowed to be the sniper. We're not going to get 6.86 here, folks.
Definitely not. Will not revert. Will not revert to that nonsense. Definitely not. So PD have their two supports, their offlaner and the safe laner. So both teams definitely are looking for some kind of mid hero. From Kaiser, Invoker has been kind of his big hero. You know, it always has been his signature.
They have the Ember too with the Iron Shell, possibly.
Yeah, the Lawnmower Ember, just run at people. run over them even. Crystal Maiden, and actually Troll Warlord is a pretty good target as well. He's very susceptible to early mid-game magic damage. He doesn't want to buy an early BKB. He's like FaZe Vlad's SNY or Manta style. Ember Spirit definitely can flourish there. It adds more mobility as well. I think I like the... Oh, maybe not now. Maybe not now. The OD is like, okay, every idea you've had in the past 30 seconds or so, no, stop.
Is there anyone other... So TA's still in, Lina's in. TA seems kind of okay.
Like, there's Ursa Warrior that you could do IO Ursa mid. Ursa's been doing well against OD mid, like trading farm and not losing the lane, basically, from what I've seen recently. With an IO there, maybe you can win the lane. But I don't know how that plays into, like, their overall game plan. That's the big question mark here for me. You know, Team Secret, you can see the kind of setup of laning phase. Mid-game, they want Earthshaker Blink. They want Omni Knight to have, you know, maybe Greaves or something like that. Arcane's mech Forstaff. OD gets his, you know, Midas and Force. Then you start breaking buildings with Troll Warlord attack speed. You just pressure up. You've got people to sit behind. You've got people to sit in the front. PD...
So that's got to be the question then. Is it going to be that Invoker? Or is it going to be that Lina then to try and handle all of that?
Yeah, because they've got no wave clear either, right?
Yeah.
Do you try and split push this out with an IO Juggernaut and someone else that can maybe run down lanes a little bit stronger than what they have now? Like, I guess PD have a lot of options. They go with a TA to kind of match up decently against the OD. I'm still worrying about how they take objectives and how they break high ground, more importantly. Team fights look okay for them. Skirmishes look okay for them. That's the thing. I think PD have an okay draft, but I think Team Secret have a good draft.
Yeah. I don't know. I like the TA. That's always the first thing that comes to mind when you see the OD. But I was kind of starting to like that Invoker too, just because I felt like he was a balance somewhere in between the Lina and the TA, whereas like TA is more like this fighting hero and like taking Roche kind of an idea, whereas Lina would have given you a very solid objective taking in terms of towers and stuff and maybe some potential high ground, but then and the stun to combo up with Darkseer would have been nice too. Whereas Invoker, though, like right in the middle, he gives you a little bit of that building pressure by giving the Alacrity onto the Juggernaut. He gives you team fight capabilities. He's going to be a little bit later, of course, but then he also gives you Sunstrike for your Nyx Assassin and IO Relocates. So.
And Split Push with Forge Spirits and TPing around. He's kind of the guy that ticks all the boxes, but I guess lane matchup is what they're looking for, especially with an Earthshaker Crystal Maiden potentially roaming around and looking for openings in these lanes from very early on. How does PD kind of deal? Like, when Nyx Assassin's in the full role, I always have this kind of, you know, toe curling moment when there's no setup stun, because I've seen full role Nyxes struggle so often. It takes me back to the days in Dota 1 where we used to see the support Tidehunter, and 25 minutes in the game he'd be level 3, and he would do nothing. Nyx Assassin has often had these kind of situations where laning phase doesn't go well. You're not a flash farmer. You can't jungle. You're not the best, you know, solo roamer. But I guess with an IO, maybe you can just run up at people and start slapping them around or something with your old claws. But we'll see how things go. We'll see how things break down as we get into the Team Tower Showdown, where no one has any levels because the game is broken for lobbies. But we'll see who's got the best one. Who's got the best
worst
one?
Worst advertising.
I think Secret has the best tower. They've got shinier things.
Oh, yeah. It's got like rotating things on it. It's definitely Secret.
Definitely Secret.
Yeah.
Oopsie.
All right, do have a little bit of a ward drop down here from Yavsor, so he sneaks his way past the Nyx, but Nyx likewise does so over here on our eastern side. So neither spotted by another. Yavsor did not bring a TP for extra sneakiness or anything like that, so he'll probably get scouted on the way out here. But he went nice and deep.
Well, they didn't see
and
him.
That might mean this isn't spotted. Yeah, because they're going to start pinging here. They're going to be like, yeah, this guy's got to be here, right? That ward's totally over here.
Is he here? Is he there? I think they've seen him now. They've pinged the back.
I think you'd be blocking this, right, for the IO stacking.
Oh, yeah. That'd be a good point. So that's something that we didn't really touch on with the IO, the ability to stack for the TA. You know, TA is so often very heavily reliant on going back into the jungle, you know, 8-9 minutes into the game to get ancient stacks and jungle stacks to kind of rush and ramp into that Desolator as quickly as you possibly can. IO is such a weird hero. Oh god, what? Wait, hang on a second. You're saying no Iron Talon, but he has no items at all. This is a naked IO.
Yeah, he was helping everybody out, it seems. It does mean... I think this block was really smart, too. The little sentry in the middle, because it's not going to get scouted right away, and if he had done the Iron Talon thing, wouldn't be able to do all three camps at once. It's pretty unlikely to get dewarded in my eyes, too.
This is the first time in a long time I've seen an IO not rush Bottle or Iron Talon. This is...
It helps that Nyx, though.
Yeah, with Brown Boots first, you're definitely right. Nyx Assassin will be able to do a lot more in lane. And they're actually running a dual lane mid, so Milan and Kai's are going to be up against the mid one OD. While over towards the Shrine, it looks like Yapzor and Puppy were maybe looking for a smoke gang towards mid. They don't have any smoke, though. I don't know what they were. Just kind of wandering around together, holding hands in the jungle, going for a merry old stroll and a picnic or something. 3-3's gone back into the jungle. Iron Talon level 1 Darkseer. We did talk about the strength of that tri lane up at top for Secret. And definitely will be pressuring 3-3 back into his jungle camp as Yapzor wants to try and steal some experience out from the DS. MP will be on the Troll Warlord at top, while bottom lane is the safe lane for PD. Garta Juggernaut even. Not Troll Warlord, that bloody Arcana. It just like makes me think of every single hero in the game except Juggernaut. J4 on the Nyx Assassin and Kezu on the Omni Knight with his stout shield up. Not going to help him against the mana burn though. Or the crit from Garta, okay. Just slaps him one in the back.
Well, it's kind of neat to see the transition of Dota right now. We definitely are getting some changes. You know, I was really hyped up for another patch to come through, but even without a patch, quite a few options opening up here, right? Like no Earth Spirit this draft, no Monkey King, the rise of Earthshaker perhaps. We've seen a couple teams trying this guy out. I mean, I love this hero, but I still feel like he is terrible. Like, you have to play so well to use this hero properly, you know? You get one spell, man. Look at this Fisher. Look at this thing. He throws it out 15 seconds, so you get another one. You have enough mana for two. Like, good luck, dude.
It's very annoying for the Darkseer, but I agree with you. You know, we talk a lot about, you know, efficiency and redundancy of heroes and, you know, farming jungle and trying to get Iron Talon and all this stuff, stacking and pulling. Earthshaker, like, can do none of these things. Like you're saying, everything has to be perfect. You have to have almost zero redundancy in your movements and your actions because you need this gold. You need this You need this time and experience. And Yapzor will take the Bounty Rune away from the DS, so already a nice little swift movement there from him. As J4 slowed down there a little bit by Kezu, finds the regen rune, but Puppy's here ready and waiting. The damage comes through onto the Nyx Assassin, but Milan tethers across. IO might be in trouble now, though, with no tether available. Puppy, a couple of seconds until he's got that frostbite up. He needs a couple of mana. Now he's got it as well. Milan, no tether for 2 seconds. A couple more hits and he's dead. Oh, no, the miss! Oh, okay. The hammer drops. Kezu's Omni Knight will get the final hit in there and get the first blood, but that was close.
Oh, yeah, and they invested so much in the poor level one of this Omni Knight, too, just by like going to this early mana burn and just butchering him as much as possible, and now Omni's going to get up into level two, so he's going to have that degen aura as well as the heal. And now Nyx is going to be very sad if he tries to toy with him again.
So
be endless punching.
Like right now, what does the Nyx do? He's pulling across one Wild Wing. It's not a full camp even, trying to deny away any experience from Kezu. But level 3.5 Omni Knight, same level as your one roll Juggernaut already. Garth is going to try and clear out this wave as quickly as he possibly can. Have they got a catapult coming? Okay, so this is the plan. It's the catapult wave coming in. So that's why it's this kind of... Well, it was a smaller pull.
Yeah, he got a stack off when he did it.
Okay, never mind.
That was good. Alright though, but Kezu comes in. He's got mana for one more plus the mango. So I think put quite a bit of pressure on here. God, he's so tanky. 5 armor, stout shield. Top lane still totally empty, so worth noting the MP does have complete and utter free farm.
Yeah, no
which
one.
Is very nice, the Troll Warlord.
Mid lane though, Kaiser, Refraction up, Yapzor has a Fissure in a second, but it doesn't look like they'll be able to finish off the TA. Mid one, Puppy and Yappy all group up at this mid lane, but they do force Kaiser all the way back to base. Actually, looks like the TA went for Brown Boots first. I don't know, has the bottle over in the courier anyway. Bring that back out to herself as Darkseer has moved over from his jungle over to the other side.
Fair enough. Gotta get some gold flowing over here. Speaking of which, already opening up about a 950 gold lead on the Dire side. A lot of that coming from the free farm up top. But mid lane, they do still have the gold edge. Yeah, they're dual laning and stuff in the mid lane. At least they were for the beginning, but it's looking pretty good for Kaiser. Feeling all right. Mid one, we'll get a shrine off here now, though. It is scouted.
Look at this control from Secret, though. Like, they've got a line of heroes from mid lane down through into the Radiant Ancients. Puppy wards up aggressively as well. Maybe they're coming behind Darkseer. The Fissure and a Frostbite, I think they've got enough damage. Because Troll...
Yeah, they want to block and force
He surged forward aggressively. 3-3, though, on the wrong side of the Fissure. Yapzor didn't get it in time. Puppy might have the damage to kill him off, though, with the Frostbite and a few more clicks in. Oh, it's not going to be enough. It's not going to be enough. Puppy very close to getting the kill, and J4 even closer there. Nearly lands the stun on the teleporting Crystal Maiden.
Oh, man. If only that Fisher was on the right. I mean, that's it, right? That Shaker. You can't miss. You miss those things. That's such a blow to your income as this hero. You need everything to go right again. I mean, that would have been arcane boots for him right there. But they secured that kill.
I just took a quick look at bottom lane as well. Kezu is running at Garto nonstop. They have left the Juggernaut in a 1v1 now because these supports have had to rotate. But look at that purification just being thrown out into the face of the Juggernaut. Garto has he's got his work cut out for him in this lane. This 1v1 is not fun at all. But
it's
maybe
not even a 1v1, man. It's a 2v1. He's got Arcane Aura.
Oh, that's
not
true.
Fair.
That's true.
Look at that. It's endless spam.
Doesn't even need a Soul Ring. He's nearly got his Arcane Boots. And there's Yappy's Arcanes. Mid lane.
Not bad.
TA is astraled. Puppy's here with a Frostbite. But Milan tethers up the TA and they miss the stun back onto the Crystal Maiden. Double traps a pop, but Puppy's out. And won't be able to chase this one down. Again, big rotations in from PD towards the mid lane to save Kaiser and try and alleviate this pressure that Secret are applying so heavily. And it's consistent as well. They're moving from lane to lane, just non-stop. Moving, like Puppy has been on every lane. It's insane. He's not stacking, he's not pulling, he's level 4, but he's just been ganking. He is a roaming, ganking Crystal Maiden.
Yeah, things are going very well for him. It's just like, that is one thing about Shaker though, the power that he has in the top lane. He can have that kill potential of a single hero. Yes, he only gets one go at it, but if he makes it, him and Troll can easily take someone, so you don't really need this 5 up there, and then Puppy will just come and clean out some jungle camps before the 7-minute mark. They do have to be cautious down bottom. Garter is about to hit 6, and he's been pressuring Kezu quite a bit. So Kezu now forced back to the shrine, full HP. So Garter now has to try and balance harassing Kezu to try and get him down to a kill percent without dying to that.
Yeah, without dying to that, indeed.
It's tough.
And Kezu has got, like, you know, 6 more of these.
Yeah, he obviously can't even now. And look, you try and he can't last it.
He's got Quelling Blade on me.
Keep the cast range away. Look at
he's got Arcane's Mango. There's no stopping this Omni Knight at this point. Absolutely ridiculous. So what does PD do? J4 and Kaiser are both back in the jungle. They've got an IO leeching experience mid, but they're all so poor. 600 net worth over on the IO. TAOK is ahead of the OD and now actually has a big ancient stack. So this is what they've been doing. Milan has been stacking up, like we said, for the TA over in the jungle. The trouble is, it's relatively early on, and killing off these stacks is not the easiest task. So another refraction is popped, and this is where the big damage comes in.
Yeah, we're getting there now. God, you want that rotation so bad right now as Garter. You're just like, please, can someone please come down here and do something? But it's a Nyx with, yeah, he's level 4, I think, at this point. At least he's getting a couple levels. Oh, he's almost 4, jeez. Again, no setup stun for being provided by a Juggernaut, so it's pretty well impossible for him to kill Kezu right now. He knows it. I mean, he's just playing under the tower, living life. It's great.
Meanwhile, J4 is trying to spam Mana Burn onto mid one, but he doesn't like that too much. Gets the Haste Rune going and runs straight into him. 3-3 has not been having the best of times either. He's doing okay though with that Iron Talon and jungling away. He's tried to go, every time he tries to go back to lane, he sits there for like 5 or 6 seconds, realizes that MP is just going to run at him as this Troll Warlord, and then goes back into the jungle to farm.
And he's under vision this whole time too. His ward's now about like 30% of its duration left, but the whole time just been scanning exactly what he's been up to. So again, just providing that comfort for Kezu down bottom. Just saying, yep, there's no rotations, no like darks are going to show up here or anything like that. No one to interrupt me.
Radiant's top
mid lane, another smoke.
I think they want to go and find the TA, but the stacks have already gone. Kaiser is still lurking around, though.
Yeah, I feel like they're... Oh, yeah, they're going to find her.
They're going to get revealed. Yaps are up on the high ground. The ward is there, but Fisher won't really do too much. Kaiser just finishes off that big old Thunder Lizard. Mr. Thunder Thighs takes him down and already more than halfway towards that Desolator. So TA really is the kind of saving grace on his PD lineup.
Yeah, they are down 2k though at 9.5 minutes. So I'm starting to feel this slipping away. They need some big team fight thing to come out, or the very first rotation coming out from a Nyx Assassin needs to be like perfect. That's pretty much the only other option.
Is Garter really doing that poorly? 3,300 net worth. Oh, they're running straight into him.
It's not bad.
I guess it's not bad, but
It's hard to compare when it's a completely free farming troll warlord. Like, literally nothing in your way, free pulls into the lane, then he just clears the wave, nobody's here. I have a Vlad's already, so I'm 100% self-sufficient. Like, he's just going to be completely out of control. And, you know, you worry about this magic damage and stuff on a troll warlord early game, he's going to have an S and Y by the time anyone tries to even kill him.
That's true. J4, is there a bash? Of course there's a fucking bash! Okay! J4 just wanted to TP. MP might even have this kill. Sure.
Honestly, he deserved that. Let's be honest. You don't do that in front of troll. You know what's gonna happen, you know?
100%.
If you're the troll warlord, never bash.
100% guaranteed first hit bash when you see a teleporting next. Okay. Garter, oh dearie me, he gets a spin off just in time before the Fisher lands, and Garter is back in behind his tier 1. So this rotation from Secret does a lot of damage and forces Garter to be on his toes and maybe a little bit scared, but he's dropped the healing ward. Should be back up to about 80% HP before Secret go in again. But this is buying so much time for mid 1 now. You know, he was under a little bit of pressure in the early stages of the game, now able to get into that hand of Midas, and now looking for a Solar Crest on the OD against the TA and Juggernaut, while bottom lane, Yapzor, here they go again, the Fisher's there, but Kezu just propels himself up. Another TP from the Darkseer will fly through onto the tier 1, but Kezu has the GA before the Omnislash pops out, with a good stun from the Assassin, with a vacuum there as well. They'll bring down Kezu, and Puppy has to retreat. The Frostbite's out, but Puppy is looking to die. 33 has dropped the wall, and in comes mid 1. The Fisher's perfect. The damage not quite good enough, though. Garta gets the spin-off again. Perfectly timed from them, and PD, they get two very good kills and retreat without any casualties.
Wow. They needed that so bad. That's like an 1100 gold swing, and they're still down 2500. That is how bad this is going right now. At like the 12 minute mark.
Whew! Not looking excellent.
But yeah, they got it. Some nice plays. Pretty well-timed Guardian's Angel from Kezu, but everyone was there to back it up, so they were still able to like force it out and then keep that chase going. Almost got turned around by the OD, but of course that hero doesn't quite hit the peaks quite yet here.
And Kezu is 400 gold away from mech, basically. As well as Arcane, this is getting insane. Desolator's done for TA. This might be the period of time where they start to look to make action happen. They just want to give Milan level 6, and he hits it. With that one final creep mid lane, he's got the relocate. Does Nyx have 6 as well? Okay, so this is the timing. They have Vendetta, they have a smoke even from J4 and 3-3. And they're going to go and look for that gank into the dire jungle. They want to find the troll. They really, really want to find that troll.
They're going to have to Iron Shell up Kaiser probably? Assuming he's... Oh, a CM. Alright, that's good. Kaiser just reveals himself on it, kills it. And then these guys are smoking past, so... Puppy feeling safe as he's under vision here.
Vendetta's there.
Take their free kill.
The Iron Shell's on J4 as well. Easy peasy. Crystal Maiden gets taken down. They have TP'd Yapzor up here as well, it looks like. Yeah. They brought him up to defend this tier 1 as the converging PD horde. Do come up to bring a bit of damage to that tier 1 tower.
And Yapzor looks great this game. Like, it's so... You know, I keep saying, I don't know how this hero's gonna work, and I always feel so bad, but some people play it, and he's got 1100 gold right now at 13 minutes. I mean, like, that's respectable.
Honestly, I feel like the two biggest things are... One, he doesn't die. Like, he doesn't ever feed as Earthshaker. I think that is, like, the single biggest thing. But the second thing is he's always, like, roaming around smoking to collect bounty runes. Like, he'll smoke for, you know, a gank, in quotation marks, but in reality, he's just smoking to get a bounty rune. He just wants to go and get gold.
Yeah, good you stuff. Basically hope there's, like, an enemy support coming to the bounty rune, and you just go as two, like, this Crystal Maiden they've been doing, and hope, you know, some other poor support, like this Nyx Sass is like, oh, I need these bounty runes, so you want to kill him when he's there, but for the most part, yeah, it's been less ganks and more ganking runes.
Oh, Puppy just walks mid lane, freezing feels a creep wave, and then walks away, realizing that there's no heroes mid, and he can apply some pressure to the tier 1 there as well. Just, it's still weird to me. It's still unusual to me seeing Crystal Maidens just throwing Freezing Field to farm. But 3-3, no bash on him.
It's great, man.
Surges away.
It's when you're killing the Ancients as Crystal Maiden where you're like, yes, this hero is finally a thing again. It feels good.
Oh, nice sentry. Puppy. They're pinging. Oh, they have the ward there as well. They've got the sentry observer ward pairing. And we'll start seeing a lot more of these. There's one over towards the Radiant Ancients as well. Just to see where the Nyx is coming in from. Because, again... Nyx Assassin, he's not just that.
Oh, but look where MP is.
Oh, he's in there. Huh? Oh, don't say anything. This is very sneaky. This is very, very, very sneaky.
Going back
Trent.
In. So he had no CA trap, and he had no sentry down or anything to even scout for it, so Like, he doesn't feel safe doing this, because I'm sure he's assuming this is a TA trap. And he's just trying to, like, pull them back.
How very interesting. But they don't know. But yeah, the Nyx Assassin isn't just this kind of, you know, ganking hero to try and pair up with a TA or something. This is the guy that gives you the intel you need. He goes in deep, he scouts people out, he looks for farming people, he looks for maybe someone AFK looking in the shop. And then you relocate on top of them and try and take him down. Another stack taken by Kaiser, and that should give him almost the Blink Dagger.
As Nyx, they really need to make these work.
Oh, Nyx has gone invis under a sentry again. They see him perfectly. He goes on to this Kezu Omni, but the Fissure's beautiful from Yapzor with the Epicenter as well. This is disastrous. The Yapzor will die. He will finally fall, but they'll lose three for the cause. Pro Dota thought it was simple. They thought they had a kill, but it was all turned around by Puppy's warding.
All right, let me just do some math here. Impale, 2.8 seconds. Okay. And who am I bringing in? An IO and a TA against an Omni. Like, what?
Yeah.
I mean, he could have just Guardian Angel. He has mech.
Mech.
That was so weird. And you're 11. Literally this close to a tower.
11 wand charges, mech, GA, purification, and repel. Yeah.
That felt so forced and desperate.
Some question marks to be thrown out there, and it looks like with the repel onto MP, the back wall gonna miss from 3-3. MP's got the Aegis, and we see the lovely timers come out there from three of them. 3-3, Darkseer, where's the bash? MP just needs one more hit, and he's got it. Doesn't even need to proc his passive. Easy kills for Team Secret, 4-7, with a 4,500 net worth lead, and honestly, this game has pretty much been sans mid one. The OD has barely been involved outside of one fight bottom lane around the tier 1 Radiant.
Well, this is definitely, I guess, what we were expecting from Secret. This is your typical Omni Knight plus one snowball draft. We've seen it with Shadow Fiend, we've seen it before with OD, and it appears to be happening again. We haven't even needed an MP this game, honestly. He's just been doing his thing. I mean, he's 4-0-0.
We haven't
coming in for the kills.
This is the thing, right? You haven't needed MP or mid one. It has been Yapzor and Puppy and Kezu winning off lane and safe lane and mid lane. Absolutely ridiculous. And 17 minutes in, they pop the Battle Trance to take down the tier 3. Does PD have anything to stop this? We talked about their lack of wave clear and the ability to shove out lanes. Kaiser goes in with a bit of damage onto MP, but he's so tanky. Even against the Desolator, he doesn't drop that low. And mid one vacuum back, so he can't TP for the efficiency play. Puppy's being chased by Garter up on top. And Juggernaut still trying to get something done.
And now what is the plan? So we have our Blink Deso. If we go on a target who is not Omni Knight, could be better. At the same time, though, of course, you're always trying to blow up the Omni Knight, because if you get him and then you can try and run them on over, it's just we don't have the control to do it, do we? On Pro Dota, like, we don't have any sort of a silence coming out. We have the stun. You're not going to be able to mana burn them in time. That's pretty much what it comes down to. If you can obviously have a Juggernaut right there, maybe if we could get like a stun right into an Omni Slash, maybe he can go down, but that's got to be the key to this engagement. But Secret, they have items now. You know, Yapzor's got a Blink. He's lining up a Shadow Blade. The window may have passed.
Maybe. Boots of Travel for OD. Like, mid one is literally just buying whatever items he feels like. Midas, Soul of Crest, Boots of Travel. Like, all these items are obviously exceptionally good up against PD. As the smoke comes in and Garter is revealed under the Observer Ward, they're looking for mid one, but they won't find anything. Garter's looking to go in a bit deep here. Kezu and Yapzor holding the line, and Puppy's coming in from the side as well. If they can catch up to any one of these heroes, maybe with a Fisher, but Yapzor is just going to farm up some creeps. Hit the crepes, and PD retreat, but yet again a smoke with no avail. And Secret group up again as 5 to move down the mid lane, with Yapzor's Blink Dagger, mid one Solar Crest, and Troll being able to just sit with the Aegis. PD, high ground defense is not going to be easy.
Oh, please don't lose your aisle right now, guys. You got this? Alright, we're good. So we've level 4 vacuum, we have the wall. Only level 1 though at 12. It's a little bit disappointing, but it's alright, still got it. Maybe this is their moment. You have some crazy TA spills of damage from the side blades.
Yeah, a Blink Meld Strike onto the Crystal Maiden or the Earthshaker before they can get into the fight and cast their spells would be good.
What's their vision look like?
Oh dear. If you want to win a fight, you cannot move your TA into the battle zone alone.
Oh, she got
but
she
a
got
good
saved.
A good relocate from Milan will actually bring her back to Fountain, it looks like. MP takes the tier 3 mid though. damage has been done.
Man, that was quite the save.
I didn't even see the tether. Like, that's,
no,
that, that's...
I didn't see the tether, and I didn't even see his little, like, white ball where he was. Like, it was, like, max range. It was so far away from the actual TA. Very impressed by Milan. I mean, this guy's always hit a very good wisp.
I honestly thought my game lagged or I crashed or something, because the TA just disappeared. There was no kill message. She just, like, disappeared. I was like, huh. Okay. Then I realized
that... Yeah, I thought she got, like, astral'd or something.
Yeah. But... Then her icon's back in the fountain. I'm just like, oh, okay. Milan, you're a player. Yeah, you've taken your TA back, but Secret have full control of this map now. Moving into Radiant Jungle, and maybe they find the TA, the Frostbite's there, and the TP comes in from mid one. Kaiser is fissured up, and a few hits in with a Freezing Field. Should be able to secure this. Sentry dropped for good measure by Yapzor, and up to high ground they go, with no buyback on Kaiser at all, it looks like here. 200 gold away from it. This is going to be a lane of barracks at the very least. Glyph is available from PD. J4 spams out the mana burn, but they found one on the south side. Milan with a Blink Echo in onto two. They've killed off three. Secret looking to take this game easy breezy.
This one is Dunzo. Take out the mid racks. Juggernaut still doing his best Madara impression. For him having some pretty crazy wins by this very strategy, but I don't know if it's gonna be enough, man. Get troll this game.
Garta's not TPing.
Show up and bash you.
Garta didn't TP, he span. He's stuck in the trees now in mid one. Has found him with the Astral. Puppy's ready with that Frostbite on top of it all, and Garta, unfortunately, Split Push will only arrive at death.
Oh no.
As Milan has apparently tried to TP in with a relocate to save his mate, but on the run, on the retreat, tail between legs, two hits is all they need. A bit more. A touch more.
Oh, meanwhile,
than two hits. Oh, what's happening mid? Okay. Okay. Is this where you just call it? Is this where you just say GG? Because J4 is pretty much the last man standing. TA is farming down a bot, and J4. You know there's a sentry here. Maybe this wasn't communicated to him. He gets a good stun, but J4 unfortunately will take a few punches, a few whacks of the axe. MP secures yet another kill.
Alright, well, it doesn't look like Secret have lost a step too much, at least. With, the, of course, the addition of Yapzor and the departure of Pylai Dai. Still looking good. Good communication all around. Again, as you said, this game really just felt won by the supports in the offlaner. Like, Yapzor, Poppy, Tezu, they did what they had to do so that the other two cores just didn't have to do anything. Just like, you know, some games that happens. You queue up for Dota, you get in this lane, and you just look at the minimap the whole game, watching your team win while you just get some creeps. You're like, guys, if you somehow screw this up, I'll be there. But honestly, I think you got it.
I'm the safety net.
That's great.
I'm the fallback plan. This is a smoke wraparound though from PD. They need this to work. They need to get a vacuum impale. They need to get Garta in with the Omni Slash. He starts with a spin, but MP, he's just going to wail into him with the bashes through. Garta is already freaking dead. The vacuum's there. The Omni Slash is around as well. But the Guardian Angel will be more than enough to keep them alive as Kaiser didn't even find a kill on the Crystal Maiden in the back end. He turns to fight against the OD of mid one, but you look at 3-3, he's dropped as well. Milan's relocate won't do a damn thing. And they call GG. Kaiser stands his ground and accepts his fate. So four heroes from Secret converge on the poor little Templar Assassin. No secrets to be held against them.
No.
As Team Secret.
Double Assassin draft not successful.
An easy victory for Team Secret. 23 minutes, 20,000 net worth lead almost. 4-17, and that was a walk in the park for Puppy and the lads.
This is definitely one of these drafts where if it doesn't go well at the start, you know it's going to look pretty damn bad. Like, this is a TA that needed to snowball like crazy. Like, this was like getting some iron shells going and the first relocate goes off with a very quick six somehow from this Nyx and things just work out, but this Omni was just let all alone. He's just like, yep, I have a support position for Nyx who I just don't even care about and is just dead after I killed him for first blood, and an IO camping mid, so I'm just gonna have my own game.
Yep.
Here, guys, don't worry about it.
Literally a free game. Four Kezu's Omni Knight. Yapzor's Earthshaker didn't fail to disappoint either. Some good fissures and pretty damn good Echo Slams as well. Mid one's warding, Puppy's warding around the middle lane to kind of scout out Nyx Assassin's movements as well. Everything from Secret there was on point. You know, I don't think PD played poorly. I think their draft really did let them down with the two supports that they picked. But it's a best of three, of course, here for the Mr. Cat EU Invitational. We'll be in a little bit.